Alright, so it's been 2 days since it snowed. The sidewalks and streets are like 50% dry. I'm here at the Transit Tech Skatepark and it's looking good. I think we're good. I was a little bit nervous. Hell yeah, not bad. Got some water. Well, quarter pipe's not really skatable. Oh well. Ah. But anyways, the goal of today's video is to talk about skatepark intimidation. I think everybody to some extent feels intimidated at the skatepark unless you're like the best one there. And I also think it's kind of unnecessary. I really think it's a shame that something kind of arbitrary like that can hold people back from getting out there to the skatepark and progressing. So let's talk about it. I'm also going to hit up a few awesome women that I know who are skateboarders, see what their insight is. So I hope that this video can be kind of inspiring for everybody. I know obviously beginner skateboarders are gonna face more skate park intimidation than advanced skateboarders. We're gonna talk about it, but for now, let's try to warm up. I never really see you blush. I never really cared for Navy. The whole having low expectations on a freezing cold day really helps me because starting to have a fun time just doing basic tricks, but if I had high expectations, I'd be all in my head about why I suck. But now I can just kind of warm up and stuff. Feels good. Going from up to down on the nollie no slide, way harder than I expected. Also, Danny's here. We're gonna get this though. As I become increasingly infuriated at my inability to do something that I thought would take a few tries, my own advice to myself would be to just accept that it's brick and your skills are not gonna be up to par, but instead I'm gonna continue getting angry and keep trying it. 10 more tries. I also had to switch my shoelace out. Ah! Here's the thing, I would like to do the whole down part, but that one, at least it was clean, it wasn't very long, but I'm gonna cut my losses, try only three more. I think I've been battling this for an hour, it's freaking ridiculous.
Hey, but that's good, but you did it twice in a row now. It's done.
Get one more.
Best one yet for sure.
You guys could probably sense that I was like over it, but just physically could not get myself to stop trying. Dude, gonna have to move on. It is what it is. Onwards. Props for skating a wet quarter pipe.
Nah, it's because I suck.
What? No, that's not what I meant. I just meant you're gnarly for that. Danny, how are you?
I'm exceptionally great, but exceptionally cold.
How's Vlogmas for you?
Looking ahead, I'm already like stressed out.
Oh yeah. I'm still in the like naive, excited phase. Like I just think it's exciting to be filming every day.
Oh no, hell yeah. I'm really stoked about that also. But then when I think about like the elements, because it's so cold and we always have to now, we're gonna have to be thinking about it's either gonna rain or snow.
Right.
It's gonna make it a little bit more difficult.
That's true.
But it's a challenge, man.
We got this, brother.
Oh yeah.
Thankfully, feeling out one frontside 5-0 grind on the quarter pipe. Instant mood boost. Feeling a lot better. Jesus. It took me 17 days to
shake you. Rearrange my mind and wake you. It could have been more sendy. Look good to me.
One day I'm gonna have that back tail all the way across the quarter like I do with the front tail. Just gonna keep working on it every day. It's all about investing yourself in that backside body language, really pushing out that back foot to make the tail slide. So stoked on the progress on that one. What's up, guys? It's a stick.
Right here, dog. The stick rule.
The rule in reference, by the way, if you say three more tries and you stick one, you get an extra try. All right, Danny, since I know you're gonna land that on your channel, I'm gonna give you this beanie for landing the front people.
Damn, dude, a beanie with my name on it?
Yeah. Plug! Always good to make sure I can still do all four trays. I'm so cold.
The saga continues. Well, I fully went for it. Got tossed.
I think that's gonna be it for the session. I actually have nollie crooked kind of a similar rail. So it's not like insane, but I am proud of myself for landing that. It was a bit of a battle and I'm super tired and stoked. And we still haven't addressed the topic of this video, so let's get into it right now. Let's talk about skatepark intimidation.
Skateparks can be intimidating, especially if you've never skated there before. The locals there or the obstacles can be very intimidating. I think especially since I'm a girl skater, it can be a little bit more intimidating for me at times because I'll get more looks when I walk into the park. People are expecting me to suck at skating, but I've been skating for a while now, so I don't really care about the other skaters at the park. I'm more so intimidated by the obstacles there. But definitely some things that I do when I go to a park that's a little bit more intimidating. I skate the obstacles that I'm more comfortable with first. So like LES, which is one of the most intimidating skate parks in the world. The first time I skated there, I skated the long manual pad that's in towards the back of the skate park because that's just what I'm used to skating. And once I got comfortable over there, I was able to work my way into skating the rest of the park. But I think it's also important to learn the pace of the other skaters that are at the park. So like when skaters are skating the same obstacle, what tends to happen is, without even saying, they'll take turns trying tricks. When I say learn the pace of the other skaters at the park, I mean just be aware of what's happening. When you're aware of your surroundings and the other skaters there, it just makes it a little bit more comfortable, at least for me. I think really when a skate park can be intimidating, just know that no one is worried about you. Nobody is worried about how you're skating. The other skaters at the skate park are definitely only worried about themselves and how they look on their skateboard. So they're not gonna be bothered by what you're doing. So if that's an issue, just know that that's something that you don't really have to worry about. At the end of the day, I feel like it's important to just go and have fun. Keep skating, don't worry about anyone else, and eventually you'll get comfortable and it won't be so intimidating anymore.
I first started skating about 3 years ago, and I remember when I first started, I would go to skate parks and just like not know what to do on any of the obstacles because I could only do like one trick. And so I would go there and be like, I'm in everyone's way. I don't actually know what to do. Is this actually fun? I don't know. If you're struggling with that, my solution would be to practice flat ground, not at the skate park, like at a spot in your neighborhood. That's what definitely what I did in the beginning. I just would skate on my street, like just practice flat ground over over and over again, and then pretty soon you can take those tricks to the skate park and start doing them like on small things, or you'll just like feel a little more comfortable because you'll have a couple like extra tricks in the bag. Another thing I guess that's intimidating could be when there's just so many people there, and this sort of ties in with not knowing what to do, but if you're like new to skating and there's a lot of people, you might feel like you're in the way. But one thing that's important to remember is that you also belong there just as much as they do, and like honestly, people will let you have your turn even if you're trying something that you think is like stupid or easy. If you're just learning like a basic trick on a small quarter pipe and someone else is throwing like crazy stuff, don't worry, like they're still gonna let you go and you can still get better and practice those tricks. Lastly, like be comfortable with just like know that everyone starts somewhere, and be comfortable with who you are, and know that no one at the skate park is judging you just for like being a girl or for being there. And if they are, like honestly, use Instagram as a tool to meet people who skate in your area. Like I live in DC, and luckily there's a pretty big group of girls. We have this group on Instagram, like a huge group DM, and people are always being like, yo, you wanna meet up? Like we're going to Charm City today, we're gonna go skate Maloof today. Like for big cities at least, there's a lot of groups on Instagram. They are like super willing to meet new people, like help teach things, like get in some people's DMs, you know what I'm saying? Like be like, hey girl, girl, you trying to go skate? If anyone's ever in DC, hit me up. We can skate. Alright. Bye.
Don't think I went to the skate park until I think like 6 months into skating. I feel like it's when you're a beginner, it's very intimidating. More than being a girl, although that's definitely like part of it. Just the thought of, oh, I'm gonna be like the worst one there, I'm not gonna be good enough. And just like the thought that somebody might like either make fun of you or just like give you crap about it definitely kind of prevented me from going to the skate park. But that definitely changed once I met a close friend who also skated, and we started hanging out and went to the park together for the first time. And definitely just having like even one person at the park that you can either like bounce ideas off of or just skate and have a good time with definitely helps with the whole intimidation factor. Just like going in with the mindset that nobody there, like 99% of the time, nobody at the park will do anything like mean or bad towards you, and it's like mainly just all in your head, and majority of the time everyone is super cool. And in terms of like the female perspective, the idea of like being like a poser, I feel like is more like prevalent for us. The idea like, oh, you're only there like either for like to meet guys or whatever it is. I never really felt that, to be honest, but I know like a couple, like I know some people that have. Yeah, I just like meeting other people, especially like other girl skaters. And so like Skate Like a Girl, there's like one here in the San Francisco Bay Area. Communities like that definitely helped.
So anxiety about going to like skate parks in particular, but literally just like outside in the public eye, has been one of the hardest things for me to kind of get past since I started skating. And there are days when I feel great about it, and then there are days when I let it get the best of me. I think there are three things that have really helped. And the first one is, in general, as women, there are so many ways that we're conditioned not to take up space. There's a really beautiful thing about skating that is taking up space, that is being in places where you're not necessarily allowed to be, you're not necessarily wanted there, and you're taking up the space, you're taking that back. And then there's something about like women doing that that's so empowering, and just coming to terms with the fact that like I have every right to take up space in the skate park, you know, wherever. And that's been a really empowering, sort of enlivening thought for me. The second thing is something that a friend of mine said to me. I was like really in my head about, well, like I'm representing like women who skate, and like if I suck, people are just gonna like blah blah, which is just like a ridiculous thing to put on myself. But he was like, yeah, but what if a young girl like sees you skating and feels super inspired? And that's a really great way to think about it. I've definitely had like little kids come up to me and be like, oh, it's so cool that you skate. And that's always just awesome and makes me feel really good. But the third thing that's probably like realistically the most tangible and accessible way for me to like overcome my sort of anxiety around skate parks and stuff has been finding a crew, but like people that I can text or hit up, or like a meetup I can go to that is either all women and non-binary people, or you know, just like people that I genuinely like being around and who make me feel comfortable. And if you can roll up with like people like that, it just makes it so much easier. The last thing, it's okay to be a beginner, and you're not gonna get past being a beginner unless you show up up and put in the work. Those are like my things, and that's sort of been my journey. And it's hard sometimes, and some days they get the better of you. I feel like that's a part of it, and just kind of lean into that. And you know, some days I'm like, yeah, I just don't have it in me. And some days I'm like, I'm gonna go and take up all the space, and it's gonna be great. And it is. So, you know, find what works for you.
The way I think about getting over that feeling of intimidation that prevents you from kind of being yourself at the skate park, or maybe even prevents you from even going to the skate park, the way I tackle this is actually kind of in line with one of my important life philosophies. So in the grand scheme of things, I believe that the more you face your skate park intimidation and simply put yourself into intimidating skate park situations and just make yourself skate even though you feel uncomfortable, I know that feeling is real. I experienced it a lot as a beginner. Still experience it on occasion depending on the crowd. Seriously, I believe the more you put yourself into that situation and just face it head on, the better you will kind of flex that muscle. If you just do it consistently, over time, over the long term, you will get better at it. It may not even cross your mind to be intimidated because you're just used to it. Now, I do think this is like a life-changing mindset if you really think about it this way, but I do know that some people need more concrete things that they can do. You can do what Danny and I did today. Show up to an empty skate park. At an empty skate park, there is no reason not to be yourself. There's nobody there to even potentially judge you. So early morning hours and in the winter season, parks do not get as crowded. Now, specifically when it comes to crowds, I know that a lot of beginner skateboarders are self-conscious about their skill level. Every single person at the skate park started as a beginner, and the way they got as good as they are is by relentlessly riding on their skateboard, which is what you should be doing, and we all understand that. 99.99% of the time, everyone at the skate park is going to be nice and encouraging as long as you're practicing skate park etiquette, which means look around and just, you know, be respectful just like you would be if you were walking in public. That's pretty much it. If you're trying hard, yo, everyone is going to be stoked no matter how insanely good they are at skateboarding, you know? Now, a more practical tip if you are a beginner is to kind of hang out in the corner of the skate park if you're kind of intimidated about really getting into the middle of the skate park where everybody else is skating. Some parks kind of do have these beginner sections which have smaller obstacles, and they do stay kind of empty, so that can definitely be a way to ease your way into really experiencing the skate park with everybody else. And I want to bring up my friend Chad Caruso, who made a great video about skate park intimidation. His point was basically that if you feel intimidated or judged by other people at the skate park, chances are that is you projecting your own fear of judgment onto other people. If you really stop to think about it, like, why not assume the best of people? Assume everyone at the skate park is super nice. Serious props to Chad for making this video. It opened my eyes. When I'm worried people are judging me for filming myself, it's probably just me projecting my own fear of judgment onto those other people. And on that note, another tip is to say hi to people. Sometimes as soon as you say hi, or if somebody does a nice trick, say, yo, that was sick. That can really crack the ice. And yeah, those are basically my tips. I'm cold as hell. Let's continue this day. Just about every time Danny and I end our sesh, we try to make a couple of TikToks. That's what we're working on right now.
Hell yeah. TikTok is life.
Yes. No, seriously, I'm very fascinated by TikTok.
No, seriously.
No, I'm serious.
No, dude, like, I am so serious right now, dude. Like, I love TikTok.
I mean, it's kind of insane that I got 10K in the week. Like, crazy. That does not happen. Anyways, let's finish up your TikTok. Right. How do you look me in the eye when I already told you? Well, you come and you go, but baby, this love ain't free. Oh man, excuse the beanie here, please. You know what? We're gonna put this back on. So it is 5:24 p.m. Pitch dark out, that's how it goes in the winter here. And yeah, actually a lot of my days look like the one you just watched. Pretty much wake up, head out, shoot a video at the skate park, and then head home. I did wanna update you guys. So had some good feedback on the red skateboarding hoodie. That is live in the description now, you can pick one up. This is not an Aero Skate Co. hoodie. I've partnered up with a merch company to make like YouTube merch. So in my head, I see Aero Skate Co. as one thing and YouTube merch as another thing. And YouTube merch would be stuff that's kind of directly related to things I talk about on my YouTube channel. But I'm starting to feel like this skateboarding hoodie, since it's kind of general, I think it's a little bit confusing. Like if you just saw me plug this hoodie, you might think to go check out the Aero Skate Co. website and buy it there. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna be selling this hoodie as part of my YouTube merch for a month only. For that time, you can pick up this red hoodie. And then I'm gonna discontinue continue it just because I think it's confusing. You guys can let me know what you think. I know it's kind of confusing. Thank you so much to everyone who helped me with this video, provided their insight on skate park intimidation. I hope this video helps at least one human get out there, go to the skate park, start their journey of being themselves at the skate park. I'll catch you guys tomorrow. I'm here at the Transit Tech. Okay, let me wait for that helicopter. Danny's vlogging too. So funny. We both looked up.